Yo, what is up, guys? It's your tech Joycey, and I'm excited today because it's an exciting day. It's an Apple event, and Apple's just announced a number of new products. But sad to say, this is the first Apple event wherein they did not include iPhone on their list. But anyway, there are a lot of new products to choose from, so let's get into it. First one is the Apple Watch Series 6 and Apple Watch SE. The all-new iPad Air, the iPad 8 generation, and some software services. So let's cover what's new and, you know, previews kung ano yung makikita natin sa launch event nila ng iPhone. First off is the Apple Watch Series 6. So it's closely the same designs ng Apple Series 4 and 5. Medyo similar sila. They included a new color, the navy blue, and it also comes in an aluminum finish. So probably yung Apple or iPhone 12 will be aluminum frame din siguro, kagaya nito. Exact polished lang yun siguro, no? Na may stainless steel pa, but I'm not sure about it. And then this is the first time na they include the product red in their Apple Watch Series 6. Ang galing, no? And by the way, guys, even though they look the same ng Apple Series 4 and 5, it has a lot of innovations. Unahin natin yung display. So yung display nila is a lot more brighter. It is actually 2.5 brighter than the... So it's 2.5 brighter kahit na saan mo siya gagamitin. But you will be using the same battery life. And ang pinakamagandang feature nito, guys, is it has a new blood oximetry sensor. So kagaya ng rumored nila before na meron silang parang infrared light into your veins, then gets a reading of your blood oxygen saturation. And this reading will take 15 seconds only. So it's very fast. And Apple is actually very happy. Advancement of health capabilities that would really help the users. So itong ano, blood oximetry sensor, you will get, you know, there will be an oxygen app on the Apple Watch. Also, your Apple Watch can take a background readings while you sleep. And because of this new sensor, guys, Apple is able to add several new health studies, including an asthma research study and heart failure and more. This would be very helpful, again, for this pandemic, COVID-19. So, magugustuhan po ito ng mga users because of that. And then, this Apple Watch Series 6 comes with the new S6 processor. This is actually based off the Apple A13 Bionic chip, so it is like 7-nanometer hardware. Now, it becomes more efficient, battery life is better because you get a better display and an always-on altimeter. What does it mean? This one will be capable of recording data and showing it in real time on an Apple Watch face. Then ang features ng Apple S6, and it is actually dual core now, so the S6 processor will be 26 more faster than the previous series or series 4 and series 5. So mas mabilis po siya. And then you will be getting a lot of Apple Watch faces. So Apple further refining their crafts, and Apple has also announced a new solo loop band. So yung solo loop band, ito yung bagong parang innovation nila. This is one continuous piece of silicone. It's well crafted and it very nice, specifically somewhat stretchy. And meron silang, it comes in different sizes, guys. Depends on the size of your wrists. So make sure na alam niyo yung size ng wrist niyo so you will be getting the correct one. It looks very cool and sleek, guys, kasi thin siya and continuous nga yung loop niya without interruptions or break-in, walang bulge. It also comes in nylon design loop, and of course this watch will arrive with OS 7, and also this OS 7 will be available for everyone. Kung meron kayong mga old watches, guys, I mean Apple Watch like Series 4 and 5, you can also avail that update, and they will be able to enjoy kung ano yung features nito. So yeah, that will be pretty adequate upgrade. And the main ingredient being the blood oxygen sensor, a specific upgrade, guys, the Watch OS 7, which Apple emphasized is the ability also to control Apple Watches, multiple Apple Watches, from one iPhone. So yun guys, pwede mong actually this new can sync a lot of Apple Watch in one iPhone. So if you have kids and you want them to have an Apple Watch and they don't necessarily have an iPhone, you can actually still monitor it all from your phone. So it's very nice. Next is the Apple Watch SE, similar to Apple Watch 5 or Series 5. Same design as the Apple Watch Series 4 as well, and 5 and 6, but slightly less capability. It has no always-on display, no ECG, and starting price of this is $279. Cheaper siya guys, as opposed to the Watch Series 6, which is $399. But yeah, you will not get all the features na meron sa Series 6. And what's even more interesting guys is yung Apple Watch Series 3. So they also include Apple Watch Series 3 if your budget will not be suitable to buy Apple Watch Series SE or Series 6. You can actually have another option to buy the Series 3. So it sticks around for $199. So it's a lot cheaper guys. It's a very interesting strategy, but medyo magulo kasi ang dami mong choices, no? But it's good that you have a lot of options and the price is very flexible. Anyway guys, there's a lot of colors where you can choose from, and as you can see on your screen, marami siyang options. The overall wide variety guys, the bands is customizable, and yeah, the customizability is really unprecedented. So I like the upgrade. Let's move on. Apple also introduced a new Service Fitness Plus guys, and this utilizes the Apple Watch in sync with your iPhone, iPad, or even Apple TV. By the way, this is a subscription service guys, so magbabayad kayo nito. You need to spend money, because again, this is a subscription service. So it starts in $9.99 a month with multiple workouts, and more will be added weekly. Looks like a pretty good idea. However, it's a little bit spendy, but yeah, you can put a price on fitness. Alright, so next, new iPads guys. Apple is starting with iPad 8 generation as well, and they've celebrated their 10th year, and guys, they sold 500 million iPads, no? Amazing. Ang yaman nila, ang yaman, they're very rich. Very impressive guys. So now, the iPad 8 generation gains even more capability and performance guys. It keeps the same design. It has now the A12 Bionic chip, quite significant upgrade, no? Kasi ang previous predecessor nito is Apple A10. So, mas ang gandang upgrade nito, guys. It has like 40% faster CPU. Ang galing. And 2x faster graphics, guys. So, you'll be able to do a lot more. And the starting price, guys, is $329. So, you will be able to use a lot of on this iPad 8 generation. Pwede mong gamitin yung Apple Pencil. You can have app sidebars. You can pin conversation and messages, top hits and notes. You can also use the scribble. You can circle to select. You can paste and handwriting as type. A lot more features for only $329. It's very impressive, guys. How much, you know, it's so impressive na yung Apple was able to release this in a very cheap price. Na ang dami mong features na may enjoy. Most capable and cheapest iPad ever. And we arrive right now at the finale, the new iPad Air series. So, Apple has redesigned their iPad. Ang ganda. Ang housing nito, wala na silang home button. It takes the design again from the iPad Pro, yung I think 2018. But slightly different guys, kasi kung i-compare mo siya sa iPad Pro, yung bezels nila, it's a bit chunkier. Medyo makapal siya, yung bezels niya. There's no Face ID, guys. And Apple also introduced a new Touch ID. So, mayroon silang Touch ID ngayon, guys, na nakalagay sa ibabaw. So, at the same time, it will be the power button. And it looks pretty slick, guys. Also, with that, it includes 3 new colors. Gold. It's so nice, guys, for the first time ever. I love it on a design like this. It looks very nice. It looks fantastic. It also includes sky blue, green. So, I like the pastel colors, guys. I so love it. I so love the new colors. It makes me really more excited for the iPhone 12. And what we can see, with that aluminum finish. Moving past the colors, guys, let's proceed to the display of the iPad Air. It's 2360 by 1640 and it is 10.9 inch, and it has all the technology from the newer iPad Pros, but of course missing 120Hz refresh rates. But anyway, that's what you paid for. We're not gonna be seeing as well on iPhones the 120Hz, guys. By the way, I know this is a disappointing na hindi mo makikita yung 120Hz, but anyway, it's still okay for me. I love the idea na meron silang home button na it will make the bezels more chunky. So they put it on top, and yung material na ginamit nito, it's a laser cut sapphire crystal. It's a machined stainless steel enclosure. It is custom sensor and tactile switch. Smallest authentication sensor they've ever designed. And with it, they've designed a new and faster Securion cloth to go with it. And also, is very proud of the 5nm process in the new Apple A14 Bionic chip. It has a faster neural engine and it has 11 trillion operations per second. So what does it mean? It's way, way, way faster. It's a very nice innovation with USB-C. So it merged the gap between this and the iPad Pro. They also deliver data 10 times faster. Please include that on the iPhone. And also, the cameras of the iPad Air, guys, the front-facing camera is now 7 megapixels. The rear camera is 12 megapixels, but they don't include the ultra-wide. And it also has stereo speakers, guys, with pencil support as well as Magic Keyboard support. So definitely bridging the gap here between the iPad Pro series with a little uniqueness. I love the new colors. I so love it. And I'm more interested in the capability of the power button, the Touch ID. Probably, kakopy nila ito sa future iPhone. They remove the Face ID, it makes the screen larger. So, we'll be expecting more, guys, kung i-release nila yung iPhone. Well, guys, I'm very excited to release ng iPhone 12. But for today's release, for today's launch, the Apple series, the iPad's a good innovation. So, that would be all for now, guys. And I hope you like my video. If you do, please do subscribe to my channel. Don't forget the hit the like button and the notification bell. I'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye!